talk to us about the difference between bias ply and radial and how that affects a tire when you're looking at a tire. Like, some people might go online and they're looking for a tire and they're like, man, this tire is a really good price. It's cheap and it's got a good tread. Is that something that a buyer should be aware of because it has a good tread, but it's cheap? Does that break down to, well, it could be a bias ply, it could be a radial. What's the benefits of each one, and how does that cost affect it?
Big thing between a bias ply and a radial is all in how the plies or the layers in the tire are laid out.
Uh-huh.
So if you look at like a traditional bias ply tire, the layers are laid out from bead to bead in a crosshatch pattern. So as that comes down the tire, the whole tire is designed to flex together. So for more low-speed riding, a bias ply tire does really well because that whole carcass is allowed to flex where you really want those flex points. To where on a radial, they actually lay from bead to bead directly across. So you can actually build more strength into a radial tire. And that's where those start to perform better at higher speeds or on heavier machines carrying a heavier load. So traditional bias ply tires are a lot less expensive to make, and that's where you'll see a lot of the price point.
Uh-huh.
But certainly if you're running higher speeds, carrying heavier loads on your machine, a radial will perform much better for you.